Hello everyone, welcome to our video. Big news today, we have a major update for our Cyberpunk Red RPG system. This is version 0.87 and it's packed full of enhancements and changes. Please note that this version is not compatible with Foundry version 11. Let's dive in. We are starting with a community update. We've moved our Discord server. It's the place to get help with this release, contribute to future updates, or just chat with fellow gamers. Join us there, the link will be in the description. Now, let's talk gameplay. In this new version, ammunition can modify weapon damage and auto-fire maximums. For example, shotgun shells now automatically roll 3d6 damage. However, if you've customized compendium items or have homebrew items, you will need to update these manually. Next up, situational modifiers. All compendium items have been set with the correct situational effects, but existing items on your actor will need manual updates. And here's something cool for your gear. We've added an is electronic data point. This won't affect the system, but it's handy for module makers and macro scripting. It can also come in handy considering that we've added for you a ready-to-use macro in the compendium. Now, watch out for this. We've made big changes to our CSS, so some modules may conflict with our CSS updates. But that's not all. We've added system-specific themes. We are shipping a few default themes, including the much-requested dark mode. You can configure these in settings. Also, we've added new compendia, including the 12 Days of Cybermas, Hornet's Pharmacy, Nomad Vehicle Upgrades, and many more. And we've updated some existing one too, thanks to our contributors. Additionally, we've improved dialogue styling. Dialogues are now responsive sheets and can change depending on inputs. You'll see where every bonus penalty on your roll comes from, and toggle situational modifiers right from the dialogue. Roll modifiers have also seen improvements. You can modify all actions with a single active effect key and toggle modifiers as situational or on by default. But please note, modifiers on set effects currently cannot be toggled situational. We are working on this and it will be fixed in a future release. Now let's talk about a big piece of this update, the sheet rewrites. The team has made a lot of changes to fix layout issues and reduce the underlying code complexity. But the exciting part? More information and functionalities on the sheet. On the character sheet, the stat block have been refactored for a cleaner layout, and it now allows two-digit values for EMP and luck. The info block has been rewritten as well. Eurobox have been moved there from the gear tab, and reputation now lives here instead of the life path tab. We've made your life easier by enabling automatic searching when typing, and by moving the sheet search filter from the right panel. And we've streamlined things by removing the HP and humanity calculators. You'll find the recalc functionality moved to the section title instead. In the fight tab, weapon actions have been condensed. Indeed, weapon will only show the fire modes it is configured to use in its item sheet. Plus, you can now see the loaded ammo type and weapon stat like rate of fire, attack modifier, damage, and hands required. Armor has received an update as well. You can now see the armor image and the layout has been updated. And don't forget about the critical injuries. You'll now see a critical injury image and display for the death save plus 1 if an injury increases the death save. Switching on the MOOC sheet, it now uses the same weapon block code and armor block code as the character sheet, and it now supports item upgrades. The Black Ice sheet has been completely rewritten as well. It now includes a damage field and copies the image from the program alongside with stats. And there you have it, an almost complete rundown of the new sheet rewrites in this update. If you're starving for more details, please feel free to check out our full update note by following the link in the description. All these changes are made to improve your gaming experience, and we hope you find them helpful. As always, if you run into an issue or have any questions, join us on the new Discord server. We can't wait to see you there. Until then, stay safe in Night City.